Hey YouTube, Kimber's Alec. I'm gonna do one of Blondie Hack's projects. Basically, we're going to make a tube with a concealed screw top. I believe she calls it a magic tube, maybe. But I'm gonna make a couple passes here to try to improve this finish. A faster rotation, a slower feed, I think will give me that. Then we're gonna part off the body of the tube. I'm gonna leave enough here to make the cap. So here we go. I have no idea of my RPMs. I'm gonna try 5/1000ths. Have an inch. Minimize the pressure. We have a terrible finish there so far. A lot of chatter here. I'm going to do one more 1000th and try to auto feed. Don't like that much. Set at 6/1000ths. Try a different tool. Let's try a little lower RPM first. Okay, we're gonna try one more thing here. I believe that's all chatter. Looks like I'm trying to cut threads. Try one more thing. I'm gonna try adding a little lubrication. take it in. About 4 1,000ths. That looks like it would hurt you. I'm going to mess around here and not have any material left to make my project. But I have an idea. Call that zero. Zero my digital readout. Go back to inches. So let's try. That looks something like turning metal. Pull that back, bring it down. So, with my setup, I think that's gonna be acceptable. We're gonna part this off now. I am going to dress this cutter up a little bit. Kind of hard to do on camera. I got this shortened up. Hopefully I got it close enough. Long enough to part it. Close enough to keep the tool rigid. I'm gonna touch there. See how we look there? I don't think that's perfect, but I think it's pretty close. So, I think the idea is to speed it up as you get closer to the center. One thing I forgot to do there, I meant, I do have a little bit of a nipple on there. I did intend to chamfer this a little bit with the file before I got all the way through the operation. And I also intended to lock the slide down, or the carriage down. Help me out here. But everything seemed to be all right despite that. We're gonna set that aside. And we're gonna work on the cap. So, I'm gonna turn a shoulder here. And I wanna try to go to about 11.75. For my 12 millimeter tap. Which happens to be the only tap I own. I'm sorry, 12 millimeter die. Being the only die that I own. I hate to take that out of the chuck because I'll lose my afraid if I move that out, this part's not gonna match the other part in roundness. Okay. We're just gonna have to go with it. We'll see how maybe we can correct any concentricity. Is that what it is? Okay, I just want to touch off. We'll call that touch. We'll call that zero. And then we're going to bring it in. We're going to try 10 thousandths of an inch. Touch the air. I'm going to set this one to inches. Turn. Tell you what. I'm gonna exchange batteries here. See if that doesn't make a difference. Yeah, trying not to get my greasy, my oily fingers on this. There we go. We go off. Go on. 2 inches. Well, I think we have a problem here. So we're gonna have to go just freehand. Well, I'm going to want to have a shoulder there, a square shoulder. I'm not going to get it like this. See if I can. Sure, if I have the reach. Okay, let's go back. Let's try this tool. I think somebody might be saying, he just got it. That tool doesn't look exactly square. Work on that. Maybe I can square that off with my cutoff tool. So we're going to advance this another 10,000ths of an inch. Call it 10.5. Speed. Let me slow it down a little bit. Get some oil on it. Splash zone. Still not getting this good square, and I'm not getting a good finish. Let me try a Let me try a fresh tool on here. See if that makes any difference. We'll try just 5/1000ths of an inch this time. 4.5. That's a little better as far as the shoulder goes. The finish is definitely better. See how much we actually have to take off of here. I'm gonna switch this over to millimeters. Okay, loosely, we have a 1635. I need to get down to 1175. Which is going to look about like that. So, go grab a can of soda or something. Finish. Another 10,000ths. Plus 0.5 thousand. Doing pretty good with 10,000ths of an inch increments. This is usually when something terrible happens. Quite a ways to go. This is usually where I'll gouge into that shoulder and send that block of brass tumbling. I don't believe I've advanced anything. It's 75,000ths. Let's go. This is 15,000ths. You get the benefit of a little oil. That's probably the biggest cut, the deepest cut I've ever made. So I got 80 thousandths now, so that's kind of 95. Try another 15. I'm getting pretty close. Let's go ahead and get a measurement on that. Okay, I'm at 1181. So I want to go to 1175. So that's seven millimeters, actually. Let's switch this over to inches. So I'm at 0.465 is what I want. No, 0.465 is where I am at. Where's a pencil when you need one? .462 is what I want. .469. So I'm just gonna creep up on this by the thousandths. So 469. .775 and inches is .462. So .462 is my goal. I am at .468, so I need 6/1000ths. Roughly, there's a half in there. So I'm gonna do 1/1000ths at a time. And I'll do two. We are at 66, so we took off two. That's pretty accurate, apparently. So I'm going to take in 2 more thousandths. I think I might have overshot it. I actually have 473 written down millimeters. I'm sorry, 1173. That's 1174. That's 1173. And 1173. I actually hit my mark. Now I need to get this square, the shoulder square. So, do I turn my post? This is what I'm thinking. But that's not going to get me all the way down to the well. It will actually chamfer that at the same time. Let's see what happens with this. We're not going to try that. Get this thing loose. Okay, I'm wondering if there's something I can do on the other piece to eat that piece of shoulder. I guess if I chamfered the inside of the female, it might allow that shoulder to exist. I do want to set up another tool and just see what it looks like. This could be a long ass video, isn't it? Feels like one of those times where I should quit while I'm ahead. That can be undercut a little bit. Chamfer that a little bit, just where the threads are going to start. That's just what I want. I've lost many a pieces right here. I think just getting too greedy. This is usually where my piece leaves the chalk. Okay. That'll be a keeper. Now we'll part this off. Another parting tool is right here. This is set. The same setting I had it on I can clear everything there. Let's put a little oil on there. Spread it around. Or we can do it this way. Quite yet. I'm going to have to stop this. Well, not necessarily. Yeah, necessarily. I'm going to get my die. Maybe we can do this. I really need my tailstock to do this. So we're going to have to shorten this long-ass video. So far, this is a big success for Kimber. No crashes. And probably the furthest I've gotten on a project without crashing. So stay tuned for another part of this, and we'll get back at it in another video. Thank you very much. Subscribe.